clearly something has gone badly wrong at that end of the ground where the Liverpool supporters are. The game has
two and
been
a half
stopped.
Minutes
nothing
after the
is
match
happening.
Started. They really
just said, just go through, you open the gate, just go in. Doesn't matter about the tickets, just go in.
Interested. They didn't say who's got tickets and who hasn't. They just opened the gate and let anybody
this
in.
This evening, 74 football supporters are reported to have been crushed to death at the FA Cup final at Hillsborough in Sheffield this afternoon.
Well, the first thing you remember was it was a nice sunny day. I was getting up early one morning, meeting mates outside the ground, and then heading off to Sheffield. And after the ground, we stopped off, something to eat, and then we went to the match. Got there dead early. I think I was in the ground about 2 o'clock, and then you knew something was up. Because it was just, I was stuck in the tunnel for about 15 minutes before I got back out again. And you knew something was up. We didn't know, you knew there was people packed in there, but you didn't expect people to be dying in front of you. Went down with 15 of my mates, we all went down and turned the trans one. And looking enough, not all 15 was coming back. But when we went out, on the way back, we couldn't find a minibus. We had to get the train back home. And I got back to Liverpool at about 8 o'clock, half 8 that night. And I couldn't, it was 10 days, I didn't have any mobile phones, nothing, just, so we couldn't phone home. I had to phone home, I got into Lime Street. My phone gone, so I was alright. I wanted to sit out and try and find my mates. And looking enough, we all come back. No, we're still fighting the stage when the season's on to get the justice. You know, it's been a long struggle. You know, we open one door and another door gets shut in your face. And we're not going to go away until we get the justice for 96. I don't just want the 96, but the survivors as well. Everyone forgets about the survivors. And they're still suffering until this day. I was 22 this time. I've 22 years been with me. You know, there's thousands of us. That's where this shop is set up. Set up to survivors.
The players are moving towards the centre circle. And the police are trying to get control of this situation once more.
I managed to get back into the stands. I was fit up, I pulled a few people up myself. You know, it's. You only pull a few people up at the time. And you're looking down there to see which ones are we getting on. It's sad.
Yeah,
you do feel good about it, but you'd always think about the person that you didn't know. How did he get out, or the person you pull up, how's he coping now? Oh, is he alright? Like the fellow you pulled me up, I never met him till this day. Don't know who he was. You know, I want to say thanks to him. But that was kind of going on that day, you just lost. What's on your mind 24/7? Oh, which we do all the time. I'd like to let the first thing you wake up of a moment, last thing you're on your mind, you expect. The emergency services have been allowed to come on the pitch. And most of the police as well, they're just standing there with hands in their pockets, not doing enough to help. The biggest hurdle that day was that the fans, they were the first to react. I mean, they make shift stretches. And they're outside the audience.
So it was the fans helping, not the
The police done a bit, but he could have done a lot more than what he could have done. It was the fans who first reacted. It could have been a lot more fatalities than the fans reacting at the time. I'm still disgusted at the papers today. I won't buy it. Never buy it. What he wrote was just pure lies. It's propaganda, what he wrote. Or something you never figure. In the headlines. Big bold letters, the truth. The shop's been open about 10 years now. So it's all been done by public donations. We wouldn't be where we are today if it wasn't for the fans outside in the streets coming in, buying t-shirts, badges, and putting money in the bucket. That's why we're still here today. So the fans on the streets coming in and helping us survive and helping us get the justice. This is the Moral Garden, and everything you see in the garden was all donated by different companies. All the plants, the brickwork and the wood. Without their help and support, we wouldn't be able to have the memorial garden. People would be able to come in, sit down. Just helps keep the campaign going. Your support is really appreciated by everyone connected with Hillsborough. Without your support, we wouldn't be where we are today. I'd just like to say thanks to everyone who backs us down the years. It's really appreciated.